The founder of the Knights of Columbus will soon be one step closer to sainthood. Father Michael McGivney was a 19th century parish priest. This Saturday, he will be beatified in Connecticut, a place where he lived a simple life of service. But the legacy of Father Michael McGivney lives on around the world. Correspondent Mark Irons reports.
A charitable Catholic organization with more than 2 million members around the globe serving those in need was started by one parish priest who saw the needs in his own small community. In New Haven, Connecticut, Irish immigrants struggled financially, faced discrimination, and their Catholic faith was challenged.
He needed to care for these families.
So in 1881, Father Michael McGivney gathered a group of men together at St. Mary's Church. It was the initial meeting of what would become the Knights of Columbus. Jonathan Reyes, with the organization today, told me about Father McGivney's goal.
He's looking at the fact that there are men who need to be grounded in the faith, and they need to take care of their families. So he wants good family men, good fathers, and he wants them protected. So he creates a fraternal organization.
Though Father McGivney would spend his life serving Catholics in Connecticut, where he would found the Knights of Columbus, he actually finished his seminary studies in Baltimore and was ordained right here in what is now the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary and the Co-Cathedral in Baltimore. Archbishop of Baltimore William Laurie is the supreme chaplain of the Knights of Columbus. In a documentary on Father McGivney, the Archbishop speaks about Father McGivney's time in the seminary.
He had a great capacity for friendship, which would serve him very well as a priest.
And today, the life of Father McGivney leaves a model for parish priests.
It's always been appealing that he's sort of a meat and potatoes priest that got the Knights going.
Father McGivney experienced suffering. While studying for the priesthood, his father died. Father Paul Scalia, the vicar for clergy in the Diocese of Arlington, says that experience of loss made him aware of those struggling around him.
He shows a great concern for those who are vulnerable, for the families who are in need.
Our world needs a witness of radical charity.
The legacy of Father Michael McGivney lives on, as he will soon be named blessed and continue down a path that could one day lead to sainthood. Mark Irons, EWTN News Nightly.